As opposed to so many faceless techno artists, Curtis Jones from Chicago is quite a personality. Since the early 1990s, the charismatic artist has been producing what he calls sci-fi intergalactic funk sound under the name of Green Velvet. Thus, a number of techno classics with names such as La La Land, Flash or Destination Unknown came to life. Under the name Kashmir, he released his more house-inclined productions and was even responsible for running two of the most influential and relevant Chicago labels, Relief and Casual. As an artist, Curtis has remained dynamic over the years and has constantly managed to reinvent himself. It was at the Electron Festival in Geneva that we confronted him with the Slicer's Catchword Challenge.
When I think of transformation, I think of a caterpillar changing into a butterfly. And so in my life, I think I had many stages of transformation. You know, there were some good ones and some bad ones. And I like to, one of the things I do know is music has always been the key for me to keep me in a good place. So that even when I went and started doing a lot of things that are so-called bad things, that I was able to make it out of those things. So as far as my transformation as an artist and a DJ and a performer, just my love for the music has always been that thing that's kept me going in the positive direction, so that instead of being a caterpillar and getting swallowed up by a bird, I was able to go somewhere else, find a nice little safe place, and then to transform into that beautiful butterfly that you now see.
Tonight is my anniversary. So you can say, happy anniversary. I've been married for 2 years. But anyway, on to more important things. I bet they want to party until the end. Looking for the after party to begin. I'm going down to I hope to see you soon in.
First thing that comes to mind for me with performances, do your best and know that it's always not going to be your best, but try your best. And just as long as you're doing something where you keep in mind who it is that you're performing for, it's all good. And so with me, I'm always trying to do whatever I can to bring some joy into the lives of the people that come here. You know, it's entertainment. So at least that's how I was introduced into the music. It's the entertainment business.
I need my body so that I can be tortured. Lord of the Jungle.
Well, an artist is somebody who's operating on a different level. It's a more spiritual level, because if you're a visual artist, be a painter, photographer, or something like that, you're trying to do something which generates a certain emotional response or feeling or something other than just the physical. And so, and the same thing with musicians, being audio artists, we're trying to evoke some sort of emotion through the audio or the oral or whatever experience. So, in my opinion, artists try to tap into that spiritual realm and try to help people get to a better place. That's what I would like to think. Of course, you got some artists who are just like reckless, but you know.
It's unbelievable. It's inconceivable. Incomprehensible. Change effect. I'm looking forward to the day when they will see.
pseudonyms are a way to be whoever you want to be. And so that would mean with pseudonyms, you're free to be whoever you want to be. And you don't have to worry about people pigeonholing you and what they think you should be. So pseudonyms are really good sometimes. Something about those little pills, unreal, the thrills they yield until they kill a million brain cells. Something about those little pills, unreal, the thrills they yield until they kill a million brain cells. Now I need to go. Who's gonna give me a ride to the after show? I hope that I have enough change. La la land. I hope to see you soon in la la land. Something about those little pills, unreal, the thrills they yield until they kill a million brain cells. Something about those little pills, unreal, the thrills they yield until they kill a million brain cells. You know, they always say there's nothing new under the sun. So whatever somebody's doing, somebody else has done before you to a certain degree or level. But I like to think of originality as being a thing which is where you're genuinely trying to do something that you think hasn't been done before. And now it may have been done before, but because you believe it hasn't been done before, that's original, you know. And being able to do something where sometimes you have to not listen to the people around you or your parents or you, or friends and family or whatever, if it's something that really is speaking to your heart. And so that may be a original thought or just some sort of original way of being. And sometimes we need to do some things which maybe in our families hasn't been done before, you know? And so I like to think being loving is one of those things where we all say like, oh, you know, love, yeah, okay, all right, peace and love, man. But to really try and be a loving person that's original, dude, because let me tell you, it's not easy. Well, at least it's not easy for me. People cut, I'm driving down the expressway, somebody cuts me off, I'm like, oh, Lord, help me. Or somebody is cussing me out, or, you know, and you gotta love that person. I'm like, okay, help me with this one. I haven't seen it, so it's pretty original. I don't know where I'm going with that, but.
But this is no laughing matter. Cameras ready, prepare to flash.
I try to do things that are sometimes very thought-provoking, and sometimes I try to create a sort of a visual image with the you know, set up the whole scene and scenario and all that stuff. And sometimes it could be intellectual, but sometimes it could just be silly, you know, because sometimes I don't want to be thinking about what I'm thinking about all the time. I just want to think about something else, just totally brainless, just to get my mind off of the whatever I think at that time is important, when it's not really important, you know? It could be something like, sometimes I can think about some stuff that I don't even need to think about, you know? And so, with lyrics, you could really have fun with it, but for the most part, I like to tee that do those things. Either it's on like a sci-fi level, which is totally fantasy or whatever, or do something that's a little bit more thought-provoking. Rhythm always was and always will be. You know, it's just like if you play some music and for a baby, you know, they start moving and start doing their little thing. And so it's just really good to see the kids just instinctively know or are moved by music and rhythm. And all around the world, everybody has their own dances, and it's fun. The funniest thing is just by dancing, you can just feel good, you know, and I love it, so.
Don't let anyone fool ya. Let me be the one to school ya. It don't take long to use the bathroom, don't let them fool ya.
Well, the first thing that comes to mind for me, I'm Christian, so I think of God and Jesus and that. And love is the message in that. So that's basically all I think about. I tried so many different religions and philosophies. I read them and studied them, and I was raised Christian. But then, you know, I went and did all the stuff that is up today's yoga and all these types of things, but made my way back to the Lord. So when I think of spirituality, I think of Jesus. Philosophy of life, plain and simple, spread love. That's it.